Hey there. I just got an email a few days ago from 00Maui00, and she actually wanted me to do a tutorial on how to flat iron hair. So, actually shampooed my hair on either Tuesdays or Wednesdays, and I decided to do it today so I can put the video up for her. So, I've already shampooed my hair, I've already blow dried it, I've already flat ironed the majority of it except for this section. And just to prep up to this stage, a wide tooth comb is of course needed. You don't want to comb your hair with a small tooth comb when your hair is wet. Terrible idea. So combing out while it's wet, blah 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 blah. I part my hair into four sections before I blow dry it. I usually go right down the middle, and wherever you have a part in the front, always part there. If you part on your right side, then you can put your part there and then go over and then go from the middle. But I do mine on my left side, so I go like this and then I go from here. So then you have two sections, and then you make a subsection to have two on each side, pin them up, and then I do one square and I do another subsection, half of that section. So I'll blow dry this much at a time. And I start in the back. I use a dimming brush. You need to get your hair as straight as possible. It makes such an easy task for you to flat iron your hair. Cuts down on flat iron time, and it actually has a different effect with the results, because a lot of people don't have the patience to flat iron their hair. So we can go ahead and pick up where I left off. Gonna need a small tooth comb. And today I'm using my 1-inch flat iron, which is right here. And then I have, I believe this is the 1/4-inch flat iron. That's just for my edges. I got that in the back of my kitchen because you need to get those. That's very important. So typically when you part, it shouldn't be more than 2 fingers. A finger and a half is good because I actually just got a relaxer. So I can do that. If you're natural or you need a relaxer, your hair is really, my hair is really, really thick. So if your hair is really thick and you haven't had a relaxer in a very long time, the smaller your subsections, the better. My flat iron is on 365, I believe. It goes up to 450, and you do not need to put your heat that high. There's just no reason for it. You can do a weave like that all you want to, but your real hair, you don't want to damage your hair. And for what I have on my hair right now is I have an oil called Simplicity Oil. I believe that's the name of it. I just bought it. I'm trying it out. I tried it out last week. But I had MoroccanOil on my hair, and you know, it blended, so I'm pretty sure I won't get the same effect as I would if I were just to stick to one oil at a time. So this week I'm doing just the Simplicity Oil to see how it goes, and I have a tutorial up on the review for that. And I'm doing my flat iron that way, backwards, because this is my bang and I don't really want to curl my hair, but I want to kind of put it in the direction of a swoop a little bit, just a little bump. And once I get done doing the whole thing, I can flat iron it any kind of way I want. But typically this is just how I flat iron my hair. Bone straight, sometimes with a small bump. And then I wrap it. I never shampoo my hair on rainy days. For some odd reason, my hair just doesn't give the same effect as it was on a regular day. And I don't like that, so. And typically, I like to shampoo my hair whenever I'm not doing anything. I don't want to shampoo it and then flat iron it and then go out. Because my hair is the type of hair that it stays better and it's flat and shiny and silky and very movable. Once I get done flat ironing, I wrap it with my silk scarf. So that's my little trick to keeping my hair down, because a lot of people will flat iron their hair, then they realize it's puffy the next day or two, and then they have to flat iron again, which then just causes heat damage, and you don't want that. Also, I don't think I spoke about why I'm using my comb as I flat iron. I'm sliding the comb down after it, just to open up the hair a little bit more so the heat can get in evenly, even though the flat iron already distributes heat evenly. So this will be my last two sections. Okay, so there we have it, and then I just want to comb it back really quickly to make sure I got around the edges. I'll show you how I use my little flat iron. This is important, you know, especially if you are trying to transition or you just trying to stretch your relaxers. I get texturizers, so I like to be able. My hair is sticking up. And I mean, like I said before, you can curl however you want to. We'll just get the front a little bit more bump and swing it to the side. And once I, if you can see, my hair is flying right here, which is fine. Because once I wrap it, it's going to lay down and it'll be okay. So I'm not going to worry about it. So once I get that flat out of my hair, I've already put oil on it. Like I said, usually I use the light Moroccan oil on it right after I get done blow drying it. Some people like to put oils on before they blow dry as well as after they blow dry before they flat iron. But I don't like to put oils on my hair before I blow dry because it leaves my hair feeling some kind of way. So everybody's hair is different. You have to find out what works best for you. What I use as the finishing touch is the Finish Glimmer Shine Spray by MoroccanOil. You can find this on my website. I just spray two times, give a little shine, and you can see the movement. And let's see if you can see that. Hopefully you saw that. If you have any more questions or you want any more videos, please feel free to inbox me and I'll put it up as soon as I can. Thank you. Bye-bye.